sequential.
You're listening to the For Frequency Sake Network. What's a frequency can at the shop in surgery?
For Frequency Sake is brought to you by Durham Remodeling, serving the Quad City area's remodeling and repair needs since 1973. Clint's Draft House, grab a bite and a pint on 7th Street in Moline. Low Pies, New York-style pizza served by the slice or pie, Davenport. Lifted Energy, energy drinks, coffee, donuts, and more, hashtag get lifted. Atomic Sports Cards and Collectibles, sports cards and memorabilia, vintage clothing, hats, pennants, and more. Yard Barbers, providing the Quad City area with all their yard care needs. Go yard with Yard Barbers. A Cut Above, offering quality custom woodwork designed specifically around our customers. Hello, everyone. Welcome to another exciting edition of the Card Subject to Change podcast, episode 91. We are climbing up there in episodes. I am your host, never wrong, Nick Bull. Joining me tonight are my trio's partners, of course, as always, the Wizard CZ. And of course,
what up?
What up?
What's going on, guys?
I hope everyone is out there is doing as great as we are. We're coming off a very exciting weekend. For the Card Subject to Change podcast, and of course for the For Frequency Sake Network. We have been hamming it up off air with our guest tonight. I'd be remiss if I did not introduce him yet. The current SCWPro champion, the Devil Dog, Dustan Moseley. Ooh-rah! How you doing, Devil Dog?
Ooh-rah! Hey, I am blessed to be alive. I'm doing great. How are you guys?
We're great, man. We're doing great. Awesome. We're happy that you're here. As much as I try to do that, ooh, rah, I can't do it as good as the Devil Dog. I'll admit it. The devil dad bod do ooh, rah, like the Devil Dog.
You got to get that deep, raspy, ooh, rah.
That raspiness. That comes with a lot of frustration.
Yeah, I bet you've earned it. You've definitely earned it. You've put in the miles, and you've got the honor and the right and the reputation to do that for sure. You've earned it. Before we delve into business, though, with the Devil Dog, it's been a couple busy days around the podcast network here, the workshop, the studio, whatever you want to call it. We've got some stuff to talk about to get off our list, don't we, CZ?
We definitely do. I want to start, and we'll transition with Devil Dog's aspect on this a little later because I know he was palling around with our good friend. I want to start by giving a shout out to the Second Gear crew and our friend, the one called Manders.
Hey.
Who walked away with the MLW Tag Team Championships recently on their latest pay-per-view, Fightland.
Yes, that is the one called Manders with his tag team partner, Matthew Justice, of the Second Gear crew. They defeated the Calling, and this would be the first major title that the one called Manders has won outside of course, of SCW out on his own in the Indies. He's up and down the highway. If you follow him on IG, social media, Twitter, Facebook, he's putting in the miles. He's putting in the reps. He often tags his stuff, another town, another show. And this guy is definitely putting in the work and the miles. And we wanted to recognize him here on the Card Subject to Change podcast. The one called Manders, part of the Second Gear crew. He is one half of your MLW Major League Wrestling tag team champions. There he is right there, hoisting up the gold with his tag team
Look at him. He's looking good holding the gold up.
Dude, he looks great. It looks good in his hand, don't it? It looks like he defended that belt and still
it's second
champion.
Nature.
Hey, he looks like he belongs in that situation. Like,
yes. I agree.
If anyone deserves it, it's definitely him, man. I miss him.
Devil Dog, you got a quick story. What's your favorite quick story about one called Manders? You've definitely you've worked with him. You've been in the gym with him. What's something that you could tell us about the one called Manders we may not know about?
He's pretty open, but I do have a funny story. You talking about putting in another highway, another town. I was driving since I had the Greenhorn, driving the car. We went to the show. It was a great show. Had a couple drinks. We get a couple drinks, and he's ready to go. We start driving home. He's passed out in the back seat. We start driving home. I'm probably a couple hours or so, like into this drive, and he just raises up like the Undertaker. I'm talking about at this point, I forgot he was in the back seat. I'm in the zone. I'm getting home and everything. He raises up like the Undertaker. He goes, "I got a piss." Pull it over.
Pull over.
Yeah, pull over. I was just like, man.
the illustration of him sitting up like the Undertaker's got me rolling, man.
Hey, it's those little moments, man. He's gotten me out and about. We've got Texas stories, Jersey, just working with him. That was another good thing. These past few months, he invited me out to do some shows on the East Coast, and man, it was just awesome. Just working and hitting those shows 5 days out of the week. Just nothing like it. Nothing like it.
Hell yeah.
That is our guest, the Devil Dog, Dustan Moseley. He is the SCW Pro Champion, chiming in about the one called Manders. We were just talking about Manders winning the MLW Championship. We've got some more business to attend to, CZ, and that you and I partook in the activity of yesterday, the Marine Corps drive for the Toys for Tots campaign. And the Card Subject to Change crew showed up along with the For Frequency's Sake Network crew and went shopping yesterday. CZ, I think that's the first time we've ever been on a shopping trip together.
I think you're right. Well, you're never wrong, so of course you're right. I'm going to just disclaimer, these pictures are in no particular order. We had our junior Card Subject to Change podcast host with us one Heath Bull.
He signed a developmental deal with us yesterday, and he was essentially paying his dues yesterday, helping us shop and pushing the cart around, and did it all day and didn't complain. So that's what I was happy about.
What's that college thing that the WWE has? The NIL? Is that what it is?
NIL. That's right. The NIL.
NIL. That's what we got him.
here's a shot of the entire crew. You can see my gigantic stomach creeping in. I was not actually in this picture, but we've got the podcast tribal chief, if you want to call him that, DJ Jarvis, Doug Green, Joe Winkle, friend of the show, and Jordan Kernan of DFS Deep Dive, who thanks to him, he put us over on his show on Friday. He didn't even know it either. That was DJ putting a preview on his graphic.
It was still nice of him to mention us on his show, but we had a good time yesterday. We were at Walmart over on 53rd and Elmore, and we filled up four cart loads of toys for the young boys and girls out there.
And then we took him over to the Illinois side of the river just off the 74 bridge and dropped him off at the Toys for Tots warehouse. We'd be remiss if we didn't tell him exactly where we went first and started picking up toys, would we, CZ?
That's fair. You're correct.
Where would you go, Stripes, if you were picking out toys? Where would be the first place you would go?
Toys R Us. Toys R Us.
Well, no, what part of the toy section?
The Barbies.
The Barbies, the Barbies for the boys, the wrestling toys. Come on now.
Yes, wrestling toys.
We picked up plenty of wrestlers for the young boys and young girls. There's CZ looking through, picking out some wrestling toys for the children. We had a blast.
Trying to find that CM Punk.
We did. We found a CM Punk. There it is. We found a CM Punk. But we had a good time yesterday doing this, helping out the boys and girls. And I'll tell you what, seeing the faces on the people at the warehouse when we dropped off our toys, there's CZ, myself, and our podcaster in training, my youngest one, Heath, helping out, holding up the flag loud and proud there, the card subject to change flag. But seeing the look on the faces of the people at the warehouse, CZ, when we dropped off that haul was all worth it. We dropped it off. We backed up to the door. A lady goes, "What are you guys doing?" We're like, "Well, we're just dropping off." And DJ opens the door of the van, and conveniently, a bunch of toys fall out. And her words, and I'll quote it, she goes, "Oh, shit." She couldn't believe how many toys that we had. So. That's awesome. It was fun to hear that lady's reaction and see her face when we dropped off that donation, that huge donation that we did. And couldn't have done it without the donation of so many generous people. I know the fantasy football leagues that Stripes you took part in for Frequency Sake Network raised approximately $2,000 for Toys for Tots. And that was the money raised is what we used yesterday to go shopping for those children make sure they have a better Christmas. Geez, guys, we're right around the corner from Christmas. So if you're listening to
less than 3 weeks,
and you feel so inclined, a toy, doesn't matter how many, a new unwrapped toy can be dropped off at the warehouse just underneath the I-74 bridge. I'm sure they would take any donations with open arms to make sure the boys and girls this year have a better Christmas come Christmas Day. If they're a lot of underprivileged people in our community. So if there's a chance that you can help them out, it would definitely be appreciated. Devil Dog, you being a former Marine, did you ever take part in any Toys for Tot campaigns? I know that's something the Marine Corps puts on.
Yeah, we did several things from Toys for Tot, Big Brother, Big Sister. It was one of the things that I would do every year is get at least 100 hours community service. And that was like one of my little check in the boxes for everything, for volunteering work and stuff.
Sure.
Yeah, it's always fun. Like just listening to your story and everything. It's very impactful to the community and everything. You really don't realize, especially like with the kids, what they're going through. But that right there is just like a neutral ground for them, and it's all positive vibes, you know. And those kids can have a little bit more for Christmas than what they're probably not going to see or anything like that, and it helps them out.
Yeah, way you put it.
There's still, with all the evil that's in the world, there's still some good going on.
Oh yeah, there's always still some good, definitely.
Yeah.
You summed it up. Go ahead, CZ.
Nick and I made damn sure that some wrestling fans are going to have a happy Christmas for sure.
Yes, we did.
I don't know. There may be one who was a little disappointed that he doesn't see anything in his box, but of course you can't see John Cena at all. So.
Right, and that's the thing too. I think about it all the time. Like the stuff that happens through pro wrestling, right? The person might not be a pro wrestling fan, but the introduction, the gift was pro wrestling, and that's how they're always going to remember you. And that toy or whatever you gave them, they're always going to remember that situation. They probably weren't a fan then, but then they get into it and they see some matches or some episodes, and then you just struck the fire in somebody, you know. And it's just little things like that where it's more than us. It's a bigger bigger moment and everything.
The bigger picture. Yep.
Bigger picture. Yes.
Just the positive vibes we felt yesterday. I know it. Sometimes it takes me a little bit to get in the, you know, the holiday spirit, but definitely yesterday got in the holiday spirit and seeing people's faces out shopping. We got so many looks with full carts pushing around, like, who are you? What are you guys doing? And kind of telling people what you're doing. And, you know, they would smile, and that makes you feel good. It does. And any little bit you could do to make somebody's Christmas or holiday better is, it feels good. And I'm not trying to sound cheesy, but it does. It makes you feel good. And yeah. Makes the bah humbug go away, and you get a little Christmas spirit. Get a little Christmas spirit lit.
You know, we're talking about Toys for Tots. We're talking about the Marine Corps. DJ did post in our comments. Good question. What different places has the Marine Corps taken you to, Devil Dog? Where in the world have you seen being part of the military?
Like, what's my favorite, or like, what's
just.
What
just different places? Different places.
Kind of where your career has taken you. Yeah.
It's taking me in the middle of the mountains in Afghanistan. I mean, the Marine Corps was interesting about that. Where, you're in San Diego, California, North Carolina, Colorado. You're in all of these places, and then Kabul, Afghanistan. You're on, you know, Camp Leatherneck, Afghanistan, and it's taken me some interesting places. That would probably be the most extreme, would be Afghanistan, and just being overseas, because at that moment nothing really matters. You're looking forward for that day, and you're not really looking at a week from then or really the next day, because everything can be taken from you in any second. Any opportunity that you're outside the wire. But yeah, it's taking me all around the world. A lot of great places, a lot of great memories, with a solid group of guys too. That question right there really needs to be a specific, but
yeah.
No, you answered there about, you know, being in the mountains in Afghanistan and how it's just a one day focus, because anything can be taken at you once, and you can apply that to just everyday life now. Makes you more appreciative. You know, so many times we talk about, 2 weeks from now I got to do this, but I got to do this A, B, and C in between. That can all be gone in an instant. And I think it gives us some perspective. Gives us some perspective that everything's just one day at a time, and it can all be taken from us. So just live in that moment and enjoy what you have, and be appreciative of what you have. Because like you said, it can all be gone in the next day.
That's right. Yeah. And the perspective, I mean, I'm treating the difference between what's going on right now in my life and what happened with the Marine Corps. Is right now, in the same time I was overseas fighting in the war of Afghanistan, and the only thing is the mindset right now. The only difference is I signed a will before, at, you know, 19 years old, to before I went to war, and now everything is just free will, and you know. But the mindset of living that day-to-day life, just taking it easy, doing the most that you can do in that day. And if you can do that, the bigger picture is always going to line up. The wars, the battles, you're going to win those championships, everything that you're going through in life. But your daily stuff, like what's the simple structure of your daily routine that is going to accomplish that goal, accomplish that mission that you're chasing? But that's just, I share the same mindset as whenever I was overseas, because I mean, you're talking about like people, like where I was at, if you pulled out a bag of Skittles, they would go crazy. Like the best thing they've ever seen. And like the excitement in someone's face over a bag of Skittles. Right.
Right.
And it's just one of those things where you really understand how to do. And the Marine Corps taught me how to do more with less, and be happy with it. Like yeah, that, no. You would be happy with those hand-me-downs that you got from another military branch, but we were about to go in here and win a war or win a battle, whatever we're doing every day.
We're talking with the Devil Dog Dustan Moseley on the Card Substitute Change podcast. We are powered by Low Pies Pizza, built by Durham Remodeling. And Devil Dog, this is your third time with the show, so we've asked you the question, why professional wrestling? So now we're going to ask you this question. What has changed most for you since you have become the SCW Pro Champion?
The mindset. The focus point of really not how I'm going to get there, but what's the statement whenever I do get there, and what's the mission that I'm on. Treating each match like it's going to be my last one. Mm-hmm. That's kind of, I've kept that mindset. I'm not promised however many matches or whatever. So each match that I have is going to be my last one. And how can I squeeze every little bit out of each one? And I'm still learning on all of that, but it's been a shift on how you're thinking and really what can the body, the mind, how can you test those limits while you're out there?
Now, you came away with that title at the 20th anniversary show here, which is a big deal as far as SCW celebrating 20 mm-hmm. years. What mm-hmm. did that mean to you at arguably their biggest show of the entire year, walking away with the championship?
Yeah, in front of how many? 400 plus?
Almost yeah, 400 plus. Standing room only.
Hey. It was a packed house. What do you mean, how did it feel? It felt damn good. I mean, especially in that situation, you're either with it or you're not, but you still had a good time, and that was a hell of a night, man. It felt it felt great because it's the start of something new. And man, like I'm having a blast doing what I'm doing now and being able to focus and hone in on really who the Devil Dog is. And yeah, you can just let loose. There's nothing in the way right now, man. I'm enjoying it.
I remember, I know you and Nick always are jaw-jacking whenever he's at a show that you're on. I was not present at the 20th anniversary show. I was driving home from Wisconsin. I remember Nick giving me a call and just so excited. He said, I looked at the Devil Dog. I looked him right in the eye and said to him, you bring home that damn title.
Hey, and what did we do, Nick?
Yes, we did.
What did we do?
Yes, you did. You brought it home. You brought it home. I know people probably think I'm trying to get some cheap heat and get in your face, but I actually said, bring home that championship tonight. And
you know
did.
What I love about that, though?
You did. Yeah.
You know what I love about that? Like, I can look in your eyes and tell, like, you mean it and you're having fun, right? Like, you're like, it's a true emotion. Like, whenever you say, bring that damn title home, and like, you're fired up. And
yeah,
that just it means the world to me. And like, because that you get in a fighting spirit mode whenever I'm out there or whenever your favorite talent is out there. And dude, it's crazy. It's awesome. Like to see that. And you can tell like you're ready.
I've always treated wrestling shows that I go to like I'm going to the movies. You know, I paid my ticket and I'm going to enjoy it and have fun. And if that means I'm going to get in a wrestler's face and yell and get them revved up, I'm going to cheer. I'm going to boo. I want to be a part of it. And I for those 2 hours you're there, you're a part of that show. You're a part of that show.
Yes.
Yelling at stripes. any of that.
That's right. You know,
but I love that's my feeling. I've always been. I'm like, you know what? When you go to these things, you make your experience. You can sit there and just take it all in, and that's your thing. That's cool. But I love to yell and jump up and down and just let it all out at these things. And that's how I enjoy these shows. And I find doing that for a couple hours, however many times I come to a show, it's a release. It's It's better than banging on the wall at home. It's better than yelling at the kids. It's great to do that and get that emotion out.
It's a good time. It's
that's
good family fun.
Yes.
Get that emotion out. Have a good time.
And to that point, one of my favorite things about going to like the SCW shows and even doing this podcast, you can go to a WWE show and sit there and you can watch match after match, but it's rare because they're on such a big level that you're going to actually interact with the wrestlers, unless you're sitting in the front row. But I walk into an SCW show, I see the Devil Dog, I see Eric Esnight, JT Energy, just to name a few people standing at the merch table waiting to greet fans. And I always come up with a big smile and say hi to everybody I can and encourage, you know. And when they come on the show, it's a big deal to me because I know the people. I've seen their work. I'm a fan of their work. Not to say I wouldn't have somebody I'm not a fan of on the show. I'll have any wrestler who wants to come on board. But I love the interaction that we get both in that intimate setting of like an SCW Pro show, the independent show, or here on Card Subject to Change, powered by Low Pies Pizza.
Ooh, Low Pies Pizza.
That brings up something else I want to ask you. You a month or two ago had the Low Pies Slice of the Month. Talk about your pizza, how you came up with that, and what it meant to be our sponsor's slice of the month.
I hear it got rave reviews. I personally didn't try it, but I think Nick, never in our wrong, Nick Bull had a piece, and it was delicious, he said.
Amazing.
It was
craziest turnout. It was a great opportunity, by the way, for Lopez to let me even do the artist of the month, right? And it was just great timing with the championship, the TED Talk speech. Everything just happened perfectly and organically. Like, we didn't stress to put it together. But the pizza turned out amazing. Like, whatever they put on it, or the ingredients with the bacon, spinach, bell peppers, and that hot honey.
Dude, that hot honey sauce is legit. Hey,
and I tell you what, I don't know if it's on the commercials here, but whenever I went back home, let me tell you, we beat Pizza Hut to it, because Pizza Hut or Little Caesars is now putting hot honey on their stuff.
Yes.
And I said, we beat them to the punch.
You were first.
We were. It was amazing. Just an amazing experience. And I was excited to see like everybody, the reviews on it. I wasn't expecting it to grab a hold like it did, but, and especially naming it like Semper Pie. Everybody laughs, right? Everybody
absolutely
laughs. Yeah. That's what I wanted, right? Like, whenever you like, well, hell, I'll just have a slice of that Semper Pie. It was a Devil
we
Dog.
Are, Hoorah!
Yeah,
we are talking to the Devil Dog Dustan Moseley on the Card Subject to Change podcast, powered by Low Pies Pizza, built by Durham Remodeling. I'm going to take this moment, gentlemen, to take a quick time out, pay some of our dues to our sponsors. We got plenty more to talk about though on the other side of the break, so stick around. We'll be right back with Card Subject to Change.
For Frequency's Sake has you covered on all things sports. From the squared circle to the hardwood and the gridiron to the speedway, we've got something for everyone. Walk down the aisle with the boys from Card Subject to Change every Sunday as they take a deep dive into everything pro wrestling. Need your gambling fix? We've got you there. Enter Pit Row with Rod Villagomez and Fast Money as we win the checkered flag with NASCAR, Xfinity, and truck race winners and props. Football more your style? Explore the waters of NFL DFS with DFS Deep Dive with Brian Craighead and Jordan Kernan each week. More into the science portion of the game? We've got a double dose of action there. The Professor John Bush and Dennis Michelson take you into their science lab and dissect your week in the data lab. Want an analytical take? Nick Girl and the team at Gridiron AI come to you each week with The Lab. Need to know who to start last minute? The network's flagship show, For Fantasy's Sake, is here in a pinch. The fellows come to you live every football Sunday from 10 to 11:30 Central with the week's best DFS, gambling, and lineup advice. And wrap up your Sundays with Joe Winkle and Nick Brinks as they come to you live with educated ignorance, looking at all the day's action. Can't get enough of Joe? He comes to you three times a week. Not enough football on Sunday? Not a problem. Kick your feet up at lunch on Monday and slip on into the football lounge with Mark and Dan while they look at the week that was in news, notes, and more. For frequency's sake, you know what we mean.
Durham Remodeling has been serving the Quad Cities area since 1973. With over 50 years of excellence on their track record, you'll see why it's so easy to trust their experts when it comes to all of your home improvement projects. Durham Remodeling's work is 100% guaranteed, so you can rest assured that you're getting the best service around. Call 309-786-6715 for all of your roofing, siding, flooring, windows, and painting needs. That's Durham Remodeling, 309-786-6715.
My name's Ryan Allison. I've spent over a decade immersed in the art of tattooing. Sharply honing my skills has materialized into a diverse and prestigious body of work. Each tattoo reflects my relentless pursuit of excellence, and every client I work with is a living embodiment of that unwavering commitment. I will gladly and wholeheartedly embrace your distinct vision.
Are you looking for the largest slice in the Quad Cities? The right spot is Lopi's Pizza. It's better than a hot dog and a handshake. They have two great locations, uptown on Brady for your delivery and catering needs, and downtown at 429 East 3rd Street in Davenport for the full experience. Lopi's is family-owned and family-friendly. Into wrestling like us, you can catch shows every day and twice on Sunday at their downtown location. Who knows, you may run into a local wrestler or a local podcaster or two while you're there. Stop by each month for a different featured slice by various artists. Lopi's Pizza, a proud sponsor of the Card Subject to Change podcast on the For Frequency's Sake podcast network.
Hey, this is Buff Bagwell, and you're watching the Card Subject to Change podcast. Check it out.
NWO legend Buff Bagwell bringing us back to the Card Subject to Change podcast.
Welcome back to the show. Yeah.
Hey, welcome back to the show. Awesome little promo there.
We are here on Card Subject to Change, again powered by Lopi's, built by Durham Remodeling, and we are here joined by the Devil Dog, Dustan Moseley. If you are a fan, give us an ooh-rah in the comments. Like, share, and subscribe. Dustan, we got something big to talk about, and we've been kind of holding off on getting there, but you were recently part of a TED Talk, and I know everybody here in the studio and our fans listening want to hear the buildup to how that came about and what the TED Talk itself was like for you and what it meant to you.
Where do I start? Man, first of all, it was just an amazing experience, just working with TEDx and Andrea. Like, she made the whole process just smooth sailing, and just listening to her and just trying to match my ideas. And how could the whole thing was, how do we take my experience that's relatable and make it understandable with the emotions and the feelings, right? What you're going through. In my situation, the stuff that happened in the military, it was one of those things where you're used to it. It doesn't bother you as much. But whenever I got out and, you know, 5-6 years and you haven't seen a RPG or anything, and now you're mistaken like plastic bags for the RPG and stuff, and starting to see it, like those visuals in my day-to-day life. And that's whenever it started bothering me, and I started getting help with the PTSD stuff. But we had to get that in 15 minutes. And it was challenging, but it was enjoyable. I understood that I hope people can take away there's still hope. Because like, if you can give someone enough hope to accomplish their dreams, and they can understand the precision that it takes to have that type of mindset, you know, anything's possible. And I'm not the only one going through these things. And that's the powerful thing about it. And having my first public speaking interaction, and it's on TED Talk or TEDx, like that was the craziest thing. And the intensity, the difference of intensity, where whenever people think pro wrestling, they're, oh, you're going to pick someone up and slam them. And I was able to hone the brakes, really grab that bull by the horn. Like, no. I'm going to tell you a story with an experience that happened to me and the skills that I've learned in 2.5 years of pro wrestling on how to tell a story, the psychology of the story, the ups, the downs, and like how pro wrestling has, with those skills and those traits, been able to help me get to that moment. And man, just, I was able to just go out there and just let it loose and tell a true story that happened and how I got back on track. And hopefully it can help someone else get to that next level, a veteran or just anybody. And that's why to tie everybody to it, that's aggressive patience. The way that I was trained was tactical patience. And aggressive patience is just something where I had to merge my military experience with my civilian journey that I was now on. And it's great to think tactical, but you've got to put things in perspective and reality and be able to make those sharp decisions. And aggressive patience, man, the thing about it is you want something so bad, but you just need to let it happen. And that's the scary thing for a lot of people. And that's why, you know, we talked about earlier about living day to day and just what can you maximize in that day that you can be happy with and contain and achieve all of your goals. And with aggressive patience, it just reminds you, you know, to keep your nose on that grindstone, but you've got to be able to switch the mindset from like the aggressiveness of hostile, that warlike mindset. And then, you know, you got to shift it to assertive, competitive, being bold, in your face. That's why I love pro wrestling. And the aggressiveness of that is just in your face. And if I'm out there, you're going to believe for however long I'm out there. And that's my goal, is to blur those lines and show you that this is as real as it gets. This is legit. I take this serious. And it's just one of those things where the speech, just how it just organically happened and the synchronicity of it. They reached out to me and heard about it. And it was all through a podcast. It is the craziest thing. You know, they heard, you know, the shift from going from military or veteran to, and how I got into pro wrestling. And it's all thanks to one person, Sergeant Major Brian Fogarty. And it's one of those things where you have all these visions and ideas and things that you want to achieve in life. And I'm a living proof of you're always one person away from a different life. And I was able to achieve everything on that list just putting in the work and accepting the help and giving back to the veteran community. And now I'm able to live that journey. And it started off as not chasing. We were going to live the childhood dream. And then through that childhood dream, I find an outlet for where I can tap into those emotions. I can express those feelings, but more importantly, I'm able to express myself in an environment where, other words, I would be scared to express myself. I would be scared to express those emotions, those feelings and stuff. But with pro wrestling, it's okay. They want those emotions. They want those feelings, those just chaos moments where, I mean, there's hatred, there's love, there's everything, right? It's an emotional roller coaster whenever you're out there. And like those matches, those promos got me ready for that speech where whenever the spotlight's on you and it's only you out there, acoustic version.
Right. Right. The day, like, you got whenever, no backup dancers. Yeah. You're all by yourself.
Hey, and it showed me that my route that I'm taking is possible and it is there. And I just need to keep hammering down and putting more fuel to the fire. And just, that was me nervous on the stage. And that was my first one. So imagine, like, I can't wait to get 10 more of these speeches, right? And it does, and yeah. it doesn't take away from wrestling, is why I love it. And it only sharpens those skills. That was a 15-minute promo. And for once in my life, I couldn't have done that 3 years ago, before pro wrestling school, because I wasn't in touch with those emotions. I didn't have the volume control on anger and, like, you know, the right moment for the outburst or anything like that, and right, the psychology of how I can, you know, express this story and a real life story, something that means something to me, that for one time I let the outside in.
Right.
And, you know, those are things that I don't talk about, but if we're going to talk about it, I want to be able to help others, you know? So that's the thing, you know, not everybody can go to those meetings. Not everybody can put everything aside. And I understand that. So how can we help in that route? And that's what aggressive patience, and we're going to build to something bigger. All that's in the process too, with aggressive patience and, you know, helping others get there and then building to that larger foundation of where, you know, I would like where I can just take people, get them off the grid. And for 7 days, you understand that person. You help that person, they're able to open up, they're able to decompress. And then that way, whenever you put them back in the civilian world, they understand it's going to be okay. And they are where they need to be. And, you know, it's just one of those things where it helped me, and hopefully it can help somebody else.
We're talking with the Devil Dog, Dustan Moseley, here on the Card Subject to Change podcast. And you said something there that really struck with me, and how does it feel when you're up there cutting a 15-minute promo, bearing your soul and being real with the people, and you know, hey, this is tough being this, you know, but I'm connecting with somebody and somebody's going to get something positive out of this. How does that make you feel?
Right. it's a surreal moment where you're able to, you know, you don't think about these things whenever you're designing these speeches, right, and putting the hours and, you know, taking 2,200 words and trying to get it down to 1,200 words. You don't think about that. But after the speech is done, I felt good because emotionally I knew I tapped into those emotions and I was able to express myself. And it was almost like just a DNA change right there, where the confidence, everything. But whenever I started getting instant feedback from the crowd, that was one thing I liked about working with Andrea. She set something up different where we gave the speech and then we got interaction with the crowd, and it was a great crowd. Like,
oh, cool. So it kind of was like a meet and greet type deal.
Meet and greet afterwards. And you're right. Like whenever you hear someone and they look at you and they just say passion, right?
Right.
And, or you give me hope. That's whenever I know that speech was delivered right. Because that's what I was going for. But that's what you needed in those situations, right? You need to know, like, hope anchors the soul. and that's how I was raised. And, you know, you got to just keep giving it 110% every single day. Doesn't matter the outcome of the day. You got another one, sharpen up, get back to it. And it's an amazing feeling to just see the reactions of the fans and of new people, because you got to understand, given that TED speech, that's not my normal crowd.
No,
right. You know, that is not an environment. It's something. And I was nervous. Like the anxiety is through all that stuff. Like where you're reaching out for like questions and help. But, you know, one thing I've been doing this year is whenever it comes to art, it's your decision. And if a lot of outside is happening, it's not your decision. And it's more like craftsmanship. You're just really putting something together with instructions. Right. And it's just one of those things where, stepping on that different platform, not knowing what to expect. It's my first time. Like I can feel my heart. It's in my throat. I can feel every beat right there. Right. And then you start settling down and it's almost like a carpet ride. If it's a drug, it's heroin, right? It's something that is just taking you on a carpet ride and you're speaking into a cave because you can't see the crowd. The lights are right there in your face. It's just a dark room.
I can only imagine.
And the acoustics of your voice hitting off those walls and you're just sitting there, the microphone's moving and you're having those nervous moments, right? But then you're just like, hey, settle down. We've been here before. You know, we've been here before. Settle down and get this across.
Dustan, let me ask you, for those of us who were not able to attend the TEDx talk live, is there a place that those of us, the fans of the podcast, fans of you, anybody can go online and watch that?
Hey, and I've got a surprise for you tonight. You can Google my name, or you can go to YouTube and just type in Dustan Moseley, DustanMoseley. And the video is online now. You guys are the first ones to actually kind of see it. I wasn't going to release anything until like this next week. But yes, it is live now. You can go to it's on YouTube.
Excellent.
Well, I know what I'm doing as soon as we're done here.
Hey, yeah, hey, tell me the truth now. I want to know. But hopefully, like I said, hopefully it can help. It can help and inspire and just get someone out there, you know.
For sure, for sure. And a lot of what you have said tonight has struck home with me. I'm not going to delve into that on air, but yeah, I'm excited to watch what you have had to say. When you did the talk, so I'm glad that it's up online. I want to get back. I want to circle back to your in-ring action. First of all, a friend of the podcast, Mr. JT Enemy, JT Energy. Maybe
you're right. Oh, JT Enemy.
JT posted in the chat. He asked if you realize that your time is coming to a close.
You know,
he's chiming in.
He just won't stop chasing me around. Just I'm gonna have to put an end to this. You know, I don't. Whenever I first got him, it was a mystery. Now it's a feline phenom. And it's one of those things. I'm gonna have to introduce him, like, and let him know that he's a cat in a dog's world. It's just one of those things where he's talking about he's upset with the situations. Well, that's too bad, buddy. I'm the champ.
He's got to learn to love it.
Hey, you try to take this. Hey, I'm hotter than fish grease right now. You hear me? Woo! And it's one of those things where you're going to have to take me to hell. But understand, the whole time I've already been there, right? You're going to have to take me to hell, beat me down in those ashes. But as long as there's a pulse, I have a breath, I can just take a breath and I can crawl my way back up, dust those ashes off, and I just look you in your face and just say, welcome to deep waters. Just understand, you're in my damn world, and I'm the champion. It doesn't matter what catchphrase you come in there with, you are in my world. And JT Energy says, my time is coming up. I'm just getting started. I'm just getting started, and I want more. I want to test these limits. I want to find those boundaries. I want to get in there and test the limits and really, really build something that can just go around the whole world. And he's just a stepping stone. He's just that battle. He's not even the main mission. But if he wants to be the main mission, I can drop him off. I can drop him off. And if he makes
not
it
even
out
the
there,
main course.
Hey, if he makes it out there December 9th, all upset, just understand. Get upset. Tough titty, said the kitty, but the milk's still good. Woo! And right now, woo-hoo! The devil dog is good.
Ooh, rah!
The devil dog. Rah! The devil dog is cooking in here. Not only is JT Energy after you, I mean, the rest of the roster is after you. As soon as you won that championship, Devil Dog,
hey,
the target got painted on your back.
Hey, it is a blessing and a curse. And like, hey, Nick, you said you target on my back, but I'm used to it.
Yeah.
It's one of those things. You get that championship, you're about to meet adversity. And the pressure is always on, and the chaos follows you everywhere you go. But just understand, that's my happy place where all of those things are combined. The pressure is on. Like, it's consistently on. You say, how does it feel being the champion? Pressure. Pressure, adversity, chaos. You've got to be on 24/7. And that's my happy place. I love it. I love it.
So talking about being on 24/7, let's look ahead a little bit to the future. I know you've got the Shug coming up next week. We're going to touch on that. But you're going to hold this title forever, I'm sure. Let's look ahead to the Prestige Rumble coming up next month. Who is your pick? Who are you kind of hoping to face coming out of the Prestige Rumble for that title?
That's a tough one.
I put you on the spot.
Well, it's just a tough one because that locker room just filled with talent, and you can go each way with it, and everybody deserves that shot. And the good thing about this is everybody's going to be fighting. And I just feel sorry for whoever does win it because I've got to do what I do. And – whoever it is,
for sure,
because that's the thing, you don't know who it is, and I don't like preparing too much for it,
right?
Because it can go either way. That's going to
keep eyes in the back of your head.
As soon as you're preparing for someone, so there's another person watching you, waiting for you to trip.
Right. Yep, that's true. How are you preparing for next week's match against a 20-year veteran in the sport in Shane Hollister?
Oh, yes.
I find a new me every time I go out there with him. Like, I find something. Like, it's whenever two styles collide.
Yeah.
It's good. And, well, you can't really say it like that, but those are special matches for me. I'm not sure if it's because it was my first match or he's just that good in the ring. But I don't have to think about anything out there. Everything's responsive. And,
right.
You know, you're in a place where you can finally feel calm. You can bend your boundaries. You can try new ideas, everything. So those matches I always look forward to. Him, Dante, Manders, Cornboy, like all of those matches, you're able to expand and just test your limits.
No doubt. No doubt. One last question before we wrap up. This is your third appearance on the podcast. What are you going to accomplish? You have gone leaps and bounds since your second appearance. What can we expect to talk about the next time when Devil Dog is on for the fourth time?
How was your trip around the world?
Hell yeah.
Yeah, I like that
because that's where we're going. I love it. Yeah. How was your trip around the world? Because I don't know if you remember, but we pretty much achieved everything we talked about. And that's something special to me because it's not a dream anymore. You proclaimed it.
It's reality. Yeah.
And that's why I love the on the spot questions and stuff, because like I said, for that moment in time, you can get the true answer in true form, genuine, you know? So, how was your trip around the world? Cause that's where my mind is going. It's one of those things I want to be tested, and I'm having fun doing this. And now I want to see what it's like in Australia, Japan, UK, Germany, and treat this like it was the Marine Corps. Yeah. And go ahead and touch down in those places. I've been there. Now I need to take the new and go over there and try that.
If you had to put on the top of your list where the most place you want to go wrestle most, what's on the top of that list?
Australia. Yeah, I'm gonna go to Australia, probably spend a couple weeks out there.
Yeah.
3 weeks, go to Japan, spend a little bit of time there, and then make my way back through. And looking at the time point, I might, go UK, Japan first, and then get Australia in its prime seasons of, January time frame.
Weather-wise, yeah.
Yeah, and it's one of those things. That's going to be the last – that's going to be my favorite spot out of all of it that I can't wait to get a hold of. I just want to spend some time there.
And we can't hear
about
your stories from when you go to these places and come back here to the Card Subject Change podcast.
Right here.
Well, you heard it here, folks. Next time Dustan Moseley is on Card Subject to Change, he will not just be the Devil Dog. He will be the world-renowned Devil Dog. I'm calling it right traveler. Now.
Yeah.
Hoorah.
Giving everybody that raspiness around.
Yeah. Oh, man. Well, that is going to put a bow on this episode, gentlemen. Dustan, Devil Dog, thank you so much. We always love having you on the show, hearing from you. We've got a fun-filled December coming up. I'm going to give you a couple previews. We've got our year in review show coming up. We've got a retro review, and I'm going to spill the beans right now. It's a good one, or is it? We will be watching. We will be stomaching and sitting through the WWE ECW classic known as December to Dismember. Yes. Tune in for that.
Oh, man.
And of course, at the end of the year, AEW World's End. But Nick, the gentleman better than I do. You've been to more Dreamwave shows than I have by quite a bit, because I've been to zero. That's going to change. Talk about what's happening next week for us.
Next weekend, CZ and I will be going up to the Dreamwave show in LaSalle, but most importantly, we'll be talking to DB from Dreamwave Wrestling. DB is the ring announcer. He will be on our show next week as we record. We'll undoubtedly
talk about... That's going to be a good
show. Yeah, we'll...
DB is awesome.
Yes, he is a lot of fun. He is interactive, and I can't wait to get him here in the studio. We will, of course, talk to him at the show. But I can't wait to talk to him about other ventures besides professional wrestling. I know he's a loyal listener to us. He listens to us and sends us pictures of when he's listening to the show. And he's a fan of the show, and I'm definitely a fan of his work.
And he's one of the co-hosts of
of the Sit Down Marks Sit podcast down Marks. As well.
That's right.
Yep. Yep. You're absolutely right. You're absolutely right. So DB will be in the hot seat next week on the Card Subject to Change podcast, talking everything wrestling.
Ooh, we got some exciting times. So stay tuned, ladies and gentlemen. This has been another episode of Card Subject to Change, powered by Lopez Pizza, built by Durham Remodeling. You have been listening to episode 91, aptly titled Beware of Dog, because we have been talking to the Devil Dog. And we will see you next week right here on Card Subject to Change.
Ooh-rah.
Yeet.